I'm Ann Kitz, and I'm Alex Colville's daughter, his youngest child. My parents, they were married for 70 years, so it was a profoundly deep relationship. I think that what attracted him to her was that they both were quite independent young people.
Come, Benny.
We met in the September of 1938 in an entering class of 10 or 12 first year fine arts students.
I wasn't terribly impressed at first when I met him, but there was something that we apparently saw in each other that we had to talk about and deal with and argue about and go on and on talking.
So then we were actually in love, you know, in every sense of the word. So that was it. And then as soon as I got into the Army, as soon as I had, in effect, a job, we were married in August of 42. Actually, our marriage, and in so far as the marriage is reflected in the art, accepts the idea that two people are actually two separate people. They are not one. They are not, you know, we can talk about united in flesh and all that, perfectly true, but you still have two separate people. And of course, it's a kind of, in a way, a rude thing to do, to throw her into this thing, because all of her instincts and all of her family instincts would be to stay out of the limelight.
There were times that it was more difficult. I mean, obviously the nudes were, I mean, she was being exposed in a way that nobody else was. And that was hard for her, I think. On the other hand, she used to joke and say, well, I would be furious if somebody else were posing for him. So she had a good sense of humor about it. And I think she just saw that as part of life. And the nice thing about it was he didn't just use her as a model when she was young and lovely. He used her for a model from the beginning until the very end. And when you look at Woman Climbing Ramp, that's a very old woman. And still for him, a beautiful example of somebody struggling against the ravages of old age and persisting in doing the things that they had done all their lives. My father did Woman, Dog, and Canoe, and she's about 60 in it, and she's poling. She's standing up in a canoe, and Dog is in the front. And when it was done, she was looking at it one day, and she said, when I'm dead, that's how I want people to remember me. My mother's death was a terrible blow for my father, and one from which she really never could recover. Obviously, from the moment she died, it was just a matter of time before he would. I think he just couldn't imagine life without her. There was a moment, I think, in sort of the last year of both their lives, as it turned out. They were sitting in the living room that's in the painting, the National Gallery painting, and they were sitting there, as they did every day, and she would kind of doze off, and so she woke up and she looked over and said, oh darling, I love you. And he looked up from his paper and said, and I love you. It's the one big fact of my life. Now that they are both gone, I think that perhaps the greatest thing about having an artist as a father is that we have this record of them. You can look through the body of his work and you'll see her at every stage. It's wonderful to have all the paintings of her and to have all his work, which for us is just a tremendous pleasure.